Start.
Hi, myself Dr. T. R. Kumar Naik, working as Assistant Professor, Department of Chemistry, Veerashaiva College, Ballari.
Today I am going to discuss about nucleic acid chemistry. It will come across in MSc second semester, Organic Chemistry paper, SCT 2.2. So, understanding importance of nucleic acid as a biomolecules, nucleic acid plays a vital role to store and transmit the genetic information and one of the generation to the next, a fundamental condition of life. Two primary constitution of nucleic acid, one is DNA and another one is RNA. DNA means deoxyribonucleic acids, RNA means ribonucleic acids. So there are molecular repositories of genetic informations. So apart from DNA and RNA, nucleotides are the structural components of metabolites, intermediates and enzyme cofactors. Thus, better understanding the nucleic acid chemistry would help in gaining a comprehensive knowledge about the various biological processes undertaken by our body at molecular level. Initially, nucleic acids was known by term nucleon by Friedrich. The Friedrich, a scientist, 24-year-old Swiss chemist, when he was isolated this nucleic acid from nuclei from pus cells. See, he isolated nuclei from pus cells at his age was 25 years. So, this nuclei from pus cells were found that they contained a unknown phosphate-rich substance. Basically, phosphate-rich substance was found in nuclei which he named as a nucleon. See, this nucleon basically acidic in nature, therefore he named as nucleic acids. So, nucleic acid are the hereditary determinants of living organisms. They are the micromolecules present in most living cells, either in the free state or bound to protein as nucleoproteins. Like the proteins, the nucleic acids are biopolymers of high molecular weight with mononucleotide as their repeating units. Because these mononucleotides are repeating units like amino acids in proteins. See, protein's backbone is amino acid. So, these nucleotides are repeating units in DNA and RNA just like amino acids. The element components of nucleic acids are carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen and or phosphorus. So, this fellow is a scientist, a Swiss chemist. He isolated a nucleic acid from pus cells. Nucleic acid chemistry is like divided into two groups. Major group is DNA and one is RNA. DNA means deoxyribonucleic acid. RNA means ribonucleic acids. See, components. See, like there are similar characteristics between DNA and RNA. Only one difference is that at pentose sugar D2 deoxyribose means at C2 there is no hydroxy functional group present in DNA, but in RNA hydroxy group present at C2. So, nucleic acid chemistry. So, nucleotides and nucleotides. What are nucleotides and what are nucleosides and what are the difference between nucleosides and nucleotides means there are not much difference. You can see here nitrogenous base, ribo, D-ribose in case of RNA and D2 deoxyribose in case of DNA, D-ribose in case of RNA and D2 ribose in case of DNA means almost similar in nucleosides and nucleotides. But what is the difference? The difference is plus phosphoric acid will present in nucleotides when compared to nucleosides. So, nitrogenous bases. So, pyrimidine and purine. This is the basis actually. Nitrogenous means nitrogen atom containing organic molecules are known as nitrogenous bases. There are two types. One is pyrimidine and one is purine. Pyrimidine means 6-member ring and purine means 6-member pyrimidine ring fused to 5-member imidazole ring. See here, two nitrogen atoms at position 1 and 3, two nitrogen atoms at position 1 and 3 in the pyrimidine ring and other two at the position 7 and 8 in the imidazole ring. So, what is the major difference is that this here only, the two nitrogen atoms at position 1 and 3, the two nitrogen atoms position 1 and 3 in the pyrimidine ring and other two positions at 7 and 9 in the imidazole ring. Basically, this is a fused heterocycles. Fused heterocycles means we are all well aware of like benzofurans and indoles in heterocyclic chemistry, first chapter. So there the pyrrol and benzene ring fused, the molecules are known as indoles. Here the pyrimidine ring fused with imidazole, the molecules are known as purines. So this is a major difference between pyrimidines and purines. So both the molecules are planar, and the general molecular formula of pyrimidine is C4H4N2, and general molecule of purine is C5H4N4. So nitrogenous bases, the nitrogen containing atom, nitrogen bases means like pyrimidine. Pyrimidine means uracil, thymine, cystosine. Purine means adenine and guanine. So here in like pyrimidine, we will come across three molecules: uracil, thymine, and cytosine. These are the chemical structures, and this adenine and guanine. So here you can see here the difference between uracil and thymine. So here the CH hydrogen is replaced by a methyl group. This is the chemical difference between uracil and thymine. And here uracil and cytosine is the ketone functional group is replaced by amine functional group. These are the IUPAC name of uracil, thymine, cystosine, adenine and guanine. So nucleosides, what are nucleosides? If you are going in depth of this molecules, nucleosides compounds in which nitrogen bases, purine and pyrimidine are conjugated to the pentose sugar by a beta glycoside linkage. Which linkage? Beta glycoside linkage. So the beta glycoside linkage involves the C1 of sugar and the hydrogen atom of N9. This is very important. So N9 of purine and C1 of sugar are N1 in the case of pyrimidine, thus eliminating a molecule of water. Therefore, the purine nucleosides are N9 glycosides and pyrimidine nucleosides are N1 nucleosides. This is very important. Purines means like N9, purine means adenine and guanine. Pyrimidine means uracil, thymine and cysteine. So the nucleosides are generally named for the particular purine and pyrimidine present. Nucleosides containing ribose are called ribonucleosides, and while those processing deoxyribose are known as deoxyribonucleosides. This table represents the ribonucleosides and deoxyribonucleosides. This is the base pairs, adenine, guanine, cytosine, thymine and uracil. And this is for DNA, adenine, guanine, cytosine, thymine and uracil. So some of the students, they will write what are the DNA base pairs means. They will write uracil, thymine, cysteine, adenine and guanine. But they won't say for DNA, uracil. In DNA also, uracil will be present. This is very important. Don't forget this. All the five like purine and pyrimidine, both are present both in ribonucleic acid and deoxyribonucleic acid. The major difference is that only the presence of hydroxy functional group at C2. So note is that the tribal name of pyrimidine nucleosides end with the suffix diene, whereas those of purine nucleosides end with the suffix syn. So classification of nucleosides, majorly nucleosides are classified into two categories like previously what we have classified. So here pyrimidine nucleosides, purine nucleosides. In pyrimidine nucleosides, again further classified as pyrimidine ribonucleosides, pyrimidine deoxyribonucleosides. Means pyrimidine nucleosides, for this is for RNA and this is for DNA. Purine nucleosides, once again classified into purine ribonucleosides, purine deoxyribonucleosides. This is for RNA and this is for DNA. So the representative structure of nucleosides, this is the structure representation of nucleoside. This is for purines and this is for pyrimidines. So nucleotides and nucleic acids nomenclature, how we can name? Actually previously we have seen that purines means adenine, guanine and pyrimidines means cytosine, thymine and uracil. These are all the nucleosides, these are all the nucleotides. So how the S-I-N-E, syn, is replaced by enolate, means adenosine, adenylate, and this is the nucleic acid is RNA. Likewise, you can go for the DNA also. The representative structure of nucleosides, this is for RNA and these are all the for DNA. So this is like for adenine and this is for guanine and this is for uracil and this is for cytosine and this is for once again adenine, guanine, thymine and this is for cytosine. Means TC. Okay. Nucleic acid, nucleotides. So we have seen nucleosides. Now we can go for nucleotides. What are the nucleotides? Means plus phosphate sugar. See here, nucleotides are the phosphoric acid esters of nucleosides. Okay, these occur either in the free form or as subunits in nucleic acids. The phosphate is always esterified to sugar moiety. In the ribose moiety of the ribonucleosides, phosphorylation is possible only at three positions, C2, C3, C5, since C1 and C4 are involved in the furanase ring formation. So this is for RNA. So you can come across, I have already discussed with you people, on the contrary, the deoxyribose component of two deoxyribose nucleosides, only two positions like C3 and C5, C2 is not there here, because C2 hydroxy functional group present in RNA here, and here it will not present, okay, are available for phosphorylation. So this is the major difference between RNA and this is for DNA. So functions of nucleotides. So what are the major functions of nucleosides? So this is like adenosine. So this is an adenine base pair, okay, purine, and this is a sugar ribose. Okay, so this complete structure is known as adenosine. So this is a phosphate group, monophosphate, diphosphate, and you can see here adenine monophosphate from up to here adenine diphosphate, and up to whole structure is ATP. This is the complete structure is of ATP, adenine triphosphate. So what are the functions of this ATP? Nucleotides may have one or two, three phosphate groups covalently linked to the 5OH of ribose. These are referred to as the nucleosides, mono, di, and triphosphate, and abbreviations are NMPs, NDPs, and NTPs respectively. NMPs means mono, NDP means like di, NTP means tri. So the three phosphate groups are generally labeled as alpha, beta, gamma, starting from the ribose. NTPs are used as a source of chemical energy to drive many biochemical reactions. Adenosine triphosphate ATP is the most widely used. Others such as uridine triphosphate UTP, guanosine triphosphate GTP, and cysteidine triphosphate CTP are used in specific chemical reaction. The hydrolysis of ATP and other nucleosides triphosphate is an exogenic reaction, and bond between the ribose and the alpha phosphate is ester linkage. The alpha, beta, and gamma linkages are phosphoric acid anhydrous. Okay, so this is for DNA only, and this is for DNA and RNA, like base pairs with phosphate, and this is for only RNA. So you can see here, this is at C2 and this is at C2. This is C2 carbon atom. OH is there, OH is not there. So this is deoxy, 2-deoxy, this is ribose. So this is the functions of nucleotides. So function of nucleotides means, like, I will give one more example. This is NDA and this is FDA. What is NDA means? Nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, and FDA is flavine adenine nucleotides. Why this NDA is so important means NDA is a backbone which is containing the structure of this molecules. What is this molecule? This is adenosine. Adenosine is of one of the compound present in NDA and FDA. What it gives, like, as a component of enzyme factors, many enzyme cofactors and coenzymes like FDA and NDA contains adenosine as a part of the structure. Okay, without this, this molecule is not considered as NDA, and this without this, this molecule is not considered as FDA. In these cofactors, adenosine does not participate directly. It will not participate directly, but the removal of adenosine from these cofactors usually results in drastic reduction of their activities. For instance, removal of adenosine nucleotides from acetoacetyl cofactor reduces its reactivity as a substrate for beta-ketoacyl cofactor transference as enzyme of lipid metabolized by a factor of 10 to the power of 6. So these are, like, what are the other functions of this adenosine means? These are all message carriers. As a chemical messengers, the cells respond to their environment by taking a cause from hormones or other chemical signals in the surrounding medium. In the interaction of these chemical signals, first messengers with receptors on the cell surface often leads to the formation of second messengers inside the cell. You can see here. You can see the structures and how the chemical transformation, how it will give the signals, we can see here. See, the interaction of these chemical signals, first messengers with respect to the cell surface, often leads to the formation of second messengers inside the cell, which in the turn leads to the adaptive changes inside the cell, the second messengers in the nucleotides. One of the most common second messenger is the nucleotide adenosine 3,5 cyclic monophosphate, means AMP. Adenosine monophosphate formed from ATP in the reaction catalyzed by adenylate cyclase. Okay, associated with the inner face of the plasma membrane and serves regulatory function. Okay, this is very important actually. We have to see this. And these are all the nucleotides linked by phosphodiester bond in nucleic acid like RNA and DNA. Okay. So, the successive nucleotides of both DNA and RNA are covalently linked through phosphate group bridges actually. Bridge, okay. In which the 5 phosphate group of one nucleotide unit is joined to the 3 hydroxy group of the next nucleotides, creating a phosphodiester linkage. It's a bridge between two villages. Like that, this phospho group will behaves like a bridge between this 5 phosphate group of the one nucleotide unit joined to the 3 hydroxy group of next nucleotide. Thus, the covalent backbone of nucleic acids consists of alternating phosphate and pentose residue, and the nitrogenous base may be regarded as a side group joined to the backbone at regular intervals. The backbone of both RNA and DNA are hydrophilic. The hydroxyl group of the sugar residue from hydrogen bonds with water molecule. Without water molecules, DNA RNA is not stable. What it means? The water molecule has to present. Okay, you can see now the DNA and RNA center, there is a water molecule. There will be a water molecule. The phosphate group with the pKa inner is 0. Completely ionized negative charge with pH 7. The interaction with positive charge on proteins, metal ions and polyamines. Okay, so now we can see how the hydrolysis reaction will happens in presence of alkaline condition. What happens in the alkaline condition of this base pairs? What will be the product, output product? The covalent backbone of DNA and RNA is subjected to slow non-enzymatic hydrolysis of the phosphodiester bond. The experiments prove that in the test tube, RNA is hydrolyzed rapidly under alkaline condition, but DNA is not. Why DNA will not get hydrolyzed? Because DNA doesn't contain hydroxy functional group at C2. You can see here. This hydroxy functional group will present only in RNA. Therefore, experiment will prove that RNA is hydrolyzed rapidly under alkaline condition. Because of this functional group, this OH ion, it will abstract this proton and then it will bond will get break. It has been found that the two hydroxy groups in RNA, which is absent, and DNA are directly involved in the process. Got it? This explains that RNA are susceptible to the alkaline attack, but DNA are not. So, what this result or experiments will lead that only hydrolysis of RNA will occur at alkaline condition, DNA is not. Why? RNA will have hydroxy functional group at C2, DNA is not. This is very important. I am telling again and again. This is very, 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 very important for you people. Okay. So, characteristic feature of nucleotides. A short nucleic acids of 50 nucleosides are referred to as an oligonucleotides. A longer nucleic acid is of more than 50 nucleotides are called as polynucleotides. So you can see here, oligonucleotides means up to 50, referred as a 50 nucleotides. So more than 50 means poly. Okay. So free pyrimidine and purines are weakly basic compounds and are thus called bases. The purine and pyrimidine bases are hydrophobic and relatively insoluble in water at the near neutral pH of the cell. Okay, these are all the characteristic features of nucleotides. You go ahead one by one. So, as a result of resonance, all nucleotide bases absorb UV light and nucleic acids are characterized by a strong absorption at wavelength near 260 nanometer. These are the one of the important feature of nucleotides. Okay, so tautomerism in nucleic acids. Why tautomerism we have to study? See here, resonance among atoms in pyrimidine and purine ring is most one of the bonds partially double bond character. Okay, pyrimidines are planar molecules, purines are very near planar molecules with a slight pucker. Okay, this is also pyrimidine planar molecule. Free pyrimidine and purine bases may exist in two or more tautomeric form depending on pH. Now, tautomerism in nucleic acid, what is tautomerism? Means the conversion of one functional group in another functional group inside the structure itself or inside the molecule itself. See, this ketone functional group will give an alcoholic functional, means keto will get enol form. Okay, this kind of structures we will come across in this nucleic acids like purine and pyrimidine base pairs. So you can see here uracil. In the uracil, actually we have like two ketone functional group, and two ketone functional group will becomes two alcoholic functional group. So likewise in cysteine, like one ketone functional group will becomes an hydroxy functional group, and in guanine one ketone functional group, okay, will becomes one hydroxy function. Means ketone functional groups, all ketone functional groups will be like all this kind of ketone functional groups will becomes this hydroxy functional groups, means keto to enol form. Okay, now chemical chemical difference between DNA and RNA. So here DNA, I have showed, like discussed much about this. RNA has OH at C2, and DNA contains, doesn't contain OH at C2. Okay, and this, now we go for like nucleic acid structure or structure of DNA. So this structure of DNA was like investigated by two famous scientists, Watson and Crick. Okay, and the model itself is known as a Watson-Crick DNA model. The base pairs of purine and pyrimidine is of the best fit in double helical structure of DNA envisaged by these two people. Purine-purine base pair is too long to get accommodated in the prescribed groove of DNA double helical structure envisaged as Watson and Crick. Similarly, pyrimidine-pyrimidine pair would be too short in the prescribed groove diameter. Therefore, it must be appropriated is that purine to pyrimidine and pyrimidine to purine, means minor grow and major grow, we can easily see in Watson-Crick DNA model. Thus, the existing base pairs of DNA includes adenine, guanine, cytosine and thymine. The existed base pairs of RNA includes, along with this, uracil. Okay, these are the two famous scientists who investigated DNA. Okay, so representative base pairs, this is like adenine, thymine, guanine and cytosine. So what are the difference between these two? Means AT is always base pair with thymine, okay, with two hydrogen bonds, and guanine always pair with cytosine with three hydrogen bonds. Not always, you can go with the other base pairs also, but it easily forms an hydrogen bonding between guanine to cytosine and adenine to thymine. Okay, so now you can see the carbon atom numbering in DNA structures. So 1 carbon atom, 2 and 3 and 4, and this will be the fifth one. So you can come across this side 3 to 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this will be the fifth one. So this is 5 to 3 and this is 3 to 5. So these are all the sugar base pairs, pentose sugar, and these are all the oxygens. A green chain will be the phosphate, and these are all the base pairs of DNA, AT, GC and C and G. Okay, so now the double helical structure of Watson and Crick, and these are the end detail of these structures, what are minor grow and what is major grow. So, and this fellow investigated on like DNA single crystal structure of DNA in organic chemistry lab in Institute of Science in 2000. 10 and he published article in Bioorganic and Medicinal Chemistry Letters. So you can get the details of this base pair of AT, adenine and thymine. What it indicates is that adenine always bonded with the thymine and thymine is always bonded with the adenine. And one more thing is that only adenine and thymine will not get bond. Always it will be formation of the complex between 2:1, means 2 adenine, 1 is thymine. This oxygen is bonded with this hydrogen and this hydrogen is bonded with this nitrogen, and nitrogen to hydrogen and hydrogen to oxygen. Okay, and this is the single crystal XRD of AT, and this is very difficult to get GC also, but I tried to get the GC, but it was not so experimental condition, and the compounds are very amorphous. These are all not so crystalline, and because of the solubility, poor solubility of GC also, and I tried in different combinations of AU and all, but unfortunately, luckily I got this structure AT, and I published the result in Bioorganic Medicinal Chemistry Letters in 2010. Okay, and this is the representative image of double helical structure of DNA. So how you can this you can see easily the major grow, and this is the minor grow. So minor grow means the space will be small and the gap will be more between the base pairs. Okay, and this has proved by Watson and Crick by their model. So if a metal complex has binds to DNA, means minor grow, and some of the metal complex in a bigger size, it will go to the major grow. Okay, and this is the structure of RNA and this is the structure of DNA. Okay, and some of the students have a confusion between DNA and RNA differences. See, if I ask the question, what is the difference between DNA and RNA, means DNA is single double stranded, RNA is single stranded. There is not much difference. This is not accurate answer for the difference between DNA and RNA. Of course, RNA is a single stranded, DNA is double stranded. But the thing is that DNA further is classified as ADNA, BDNA and ZDNA. Okay, depend on their helical structure. And DNA is also called as double stranded DNA. And in DNA itself, we have a single stranded calf thymus ctDNA. So therefore, the answer somewhere it will get confusion between. So what is the single stranded DNA? Yes, of course, single stranded DNA is also there, means like calf thymus DNA, we will call it as a like a single stranded DNA, or in other words, calf thymus ctDNA. Double stranded means dsDNA. So what is the appropriate answer is that the difference between RNA and DNA is, the first one is RNA is having a hydroxy functional group at C2 carbon atom, and DNA doesn't have hydroxy functional group at C2 carbon atom. And the next is point is that RNA is a single stranded, of course, DNA is double stranded. Instead of writing that ribonucleic acid and deoxyribonucleic acid, in DNA further double stranded DNA and ctDNA, calf thymus DNA. So these are all the points we have to include in the difference between DNA and RNA. So due to coronavirus, all students are like protected themselves and they are staying at home. And my request is that stay home, stay safe and stay lives. Thank you. So if you have any doubts regarding this topic, nucleic acids, kindly write to my email ID I have shown in the beginning, or you can call me, or you can drop a SMS regarding that, so I can clarify your doubts. Thank you.